गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट अवर फिफ्थ चैप्टर हेल्थ एंड डिजीजेस। व्हाई डू वी नीड फूड? वी नीड फूड टू स्टे अलाइव एंड रिमेन हेल्दी। सो फूड इज इम्पॉर्टेंट टू स्टे अलाइव एंड रिमेन हेल्दी। द फूड वी ईट इज कॉल्ड डाइट। आवर डाइट इज मेड अप ऑफ डिफरेंट कॉम्पोनेंट्स एंड दीज कॉम्पोनेंट्स आर कॉल्ड एज न्यूट्रिएंट्स एंड दे हेल्प अस टू ग्रो, स्टे फिट एंड हेल्दी। There are five main nutrients. They are carbohydrates, proteins, minerals, fats and vitamins. When we must eat right amount of each nutrient to stay healthy. Next is balanced diet. So what is balanced diet? A diet which contains all the nutrients in the right amount along with water and roughage. First type of nutrient is carbohydrates. Carbohydrates, it provide energy to the body. So it is also known as energy giving foods, and the sources are potatoes, bread, rice and cereal. Next type of nutrients are fats. Fats are also known as energy giving foods. It helps to keep our body warm, and the sources are butter, oil, ghee, cheese and nuts are the sources of fat. Next type of nutrients are proteins. Proteins are bodybuilding food that help the body to grow, build new cells, repair damaged tissue and help regain strength after illness. So proteins are essential for growth and muscle building. Next is vitamins and minerals. Vitamins and minerals are protective food that protect us and give strength to fight against diseases. And the sources of vitamins and minerals are fresh fruits and vegetables. They are required in small quantities by our body. Next is roughage. Roughage is a fiber in our food that makes our digestion smooth and easy and helps to carry waste materials from digestive system out of the body. So roughage is also an important part of our diet. Next is water. Water does not contain any nutrient, but it is important to drink 6 to 8 glasses of water daily, because water helps in digestion and is the major component of blood and maintains constant body temperature and helps in transport of substance within the body and also helps in removing body waste in the form of urine and sweat. Next is exercise. Exercise is the activity that uses the muscles of the body. Exercise is important because it helps in proper digestion of food, makes us feel energetic and active, help tone our muscles, stay lean and keep our body in good health and shape, improves breathing and blood circulation and makes muscle stronger. So exercise is also necessary. Then rest. The body needs rest after a day's hard work, a good sleep, because it gives rest to the body system. It gives our body a chance to repair its wear and tear and helps in keeping our mind and body health. We need at least 7 to 8 hours of undisturbed sleep every day. So it is important to take rest also for the good health. Next is disease. A disease is an illness that affects the health of a person. Or we can say that when one feel unwell, it is an unhealthy condition that does not allow the body to function properly. And we feel very weak. If we are not feeling well, we feel very weak and restless. Next is type of diseases. There are two types of diseases. First is communicable or infectious disease. Second one is non-communicable or non-infectious disease. So communicable disease, the disease which spread from a person to a healthy person or a sick person to a healthy person, is known as communicable disease. And these diseases are caused by the germs. Germs are microorganisms which we cannot see with our eyes. The germs are carried through by direct contact. A sick person through direct contact means a sick person or by sharing common things like towel, handkerchief or clothing. And the disease which which caused by direct contact are chickenpox, measles, mumps. Next is by air. Diseases like common cold, influenza, chickenpox, smallpox spread through air and are called airborne disease. So the disease which is caused by air is known as airborne diseases. Example, chickenpox and smallpox. When a person suffering from a disease coughs, sneezes or spits, the disease causing germs come out into the air and spread around. When another person breathes in the air, germs enter his body and make him sick. We should cover our mouth while coughing or sneezing. So it is very important to cover our mouth while coughing or sneezing to protect from these diseases. Next is contaminated water and contaminated food. Contaminated means dirty or not clean. So the disease which is caused by contaminated water and contaminated food are typhoid, cholera, jaundice and food poisoning. When water is not stored or handled properly, they can easily infected by germs. So we have to always cover the water properly, otherwise we may be infected by germs. So we should drink boiled or filtered water, and water should not be allowed to collect in our surroundings and neighborhood. Contaminated food, uncovered food attracted by flies and dust. Then flies carry germs on their bodies and pass them on to the uncovered food or water when they sit on them. So we should not eat roadside food, otherwise we may be caused by food poisoning. Next is animal bites. Some animals carry germs or different diseases in their body. Their bite transfer these diseases to the person and cause diseases. Diseases like rabies spread through a dog bite. A doctor should be consulted immediately in case of an animal bite. See, dog bite spreads rabies. Next is insect bite. Some insect bite carry diseases causing germs. Such insects are called vectors. When these vectors bite a sick person, they suck blood containing germs and germs of the disease. When the same insect bites a healthy person, germs are transferred to the body. Just mosquito and flies are the most common vectors. Common disease spread by the insect bites are malaria, dengue and chikungunya. So we should keep our surroundings clean and not let insects breed. Some of the communicable diseases can be treated by taking vaccination. Vaccination is the use of special substance called vaccines. Vaccines protect a person from disease by killing the diseases causing microorganism and reducing risk of infection. The process of injecting vaccine into the body of a healthy person is called vaccination. Most of the vaccines you all are taking in your infants, in your early ages. Second type of diseases are non-communicable or non-infectious diseases. So the disease which do not transmit or do not transfer or do not spread from one person to another are called non-communicable diseases. They are not caused by germs, but communicable diseases are caused by germs. These diseases, so non-communicable diseases are caused by deficiency of the nutrient in the body, lack of physical activity or poor functioning of any body part. Some examples are diabetes, blood pressure, cancer, obesity and heart disease. Some such diseases are passed from generation to generation, that is a child inherits disorders from its parents. Inherits means the disease which passes from parents to children. When we do not have balanced diet, certain diseases are caused due to deficiency of any nutrients, such as vitamin A. Deficiency of vitamin A causes night blindness, vitamin B beriberi, vitamin C scurvy. Lack of vitamin D causes rickets, lack of vitamin E pale skin, lack of vitamin K, excessive loss of blood. Some of the minerals, some of the diseases caused by minerals or deficiency of minerals also. Calcium and phosphorus causes poor growth of bones and teeth. From iron, lack of iron causes anemia, lack of iodine causes goiter, and lack of sodium and potassium causes improper function of muscles and nerves, imbalance of water in our body. So children, the chapter has been done. Please refer the PDF file which is downloaded and do the exercise in your classwork copy. Thank you.